Ông cười chụp. Ông chuẩn bị ra phát cảm tỏ khai tâm là ca này tệp thị xã mạng ca. Xã mạng ca này thằng ngày này ông chỉ phát phương xã mạng ca phát đọc tờ khai cam xã thấy đại miền hạt dân niêm vì thị xị bởi dư mà bọn xài tập rằm. Làm chi xã mạng ca cả nhà chia siêu hóng là gửi cam vì sản phẩm bọt miền áo bọt miền phị ký nâng bọc khu này ông chỉ phát. Còn hình chưa hình châu rùm được nông cạnh tâm là ca xã mạng ca thằng ngày này.
សូមគោរពលោកប្រធានសម្រាប់សំណាកការនៅថ្ងៃនេះក្រុមជីកិច្ចសម្គាល់ឃើញថាគ្រប់ភាគីទាំងអស់នៅរឿងក្តីនេះមានវត្តមានលើកឡើងតែលោកស្រីម៉ារីហ្គីរ៉ូមេធាវីអន្តរជាតិនាំមុខតំណាងដើមបណ្ដឹងរដ្ឋបវេនីដែលបានជួយដំណឹងមកថានឹងអវត្តមាននៅថ្ងៃនេះដោយមូលហេតុតខ្លួនដោយឡែកលោកនួនជាមានវត្តមាននៅបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនខាងក្រោមសារសំណាកការនេះដែលលោកសារសុំលះបង់សិទ្ធិមានវត្តមានដែលផ្ទាល់ទីបន្ទប់សំណាកការនៅថ្ សាក់សីបានធ្វើសម្បត្តិនៅចំពោះមុខលោកតាដំបងដែករួចហើយកាលពីម្សិលមិញនេះសាក់សីនៅមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាគឺលោកដូចផារីមានវត្តមានរួចហើយនៅក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្ណាការនេះសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
បាទអរគុណកញ្ញាជាស៊ីហ្វងជាដំបងនេះអង្គជំរះសម្រេចលើសំណើសុំរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាជាមុនសិនអង្គជំរះបានទទួលលិខិតសូមលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមសម្ណការដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សម្ណការនេះរបស់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចុះថ្ងៃទី27ខែតុលាឆ្នាំ2016បានបញ្ជាក់ថាដែលគាត់មានបញ្ហាសុខភាពជាក្បាលឈឺចង្កេះមិនអាចអង្គុយយូរបានមិនអាចផ្ចង់អារម្មណ៍បានយូរនឹងដើម្បីមានលទ្ធភាពចូលរួមសកម្មភាពនាថ្ងៃខាងមុខឲ្យមានប្រសិទ្ធភាពខ្លួនធំលះបង់សិទ្ធចូលរួមនឹងមានវត្តមានដែលផ្ទាល់ក្នុងបន្ទប់សកម្មភាពនៅថ្ងៃទី27ខែតុលាឆ្នាំ2016បានឃើញកំណត់ហេតុពិនិត្យសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាដែលធ្វើឡើងដោយគ្រូពេទ្យប្រចាំការពិនិត្យព្យាបាលថែទាំសុខភាពជនជាប់ចោតនៅអវតកចុះថ្ងៃទី27ខែតុលាឆ្នាំ2016បានកត់ត្រាពីសន្តិភាពសុខភាពរបស់លោកនួនជានៅថ្ងៃនេះថាមានអាការៈឈឺចង្កេះខ្លាំងនិងវិលមុខពេលអង្គុយនិងបានផ្ដល់អនុសាសន៍ថាសូមឲ្យអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យលោកនួនជាចូលរួមតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីបន្ទប់ខាងក្រោមសាធារណការនេះផ្អែកលើមូលដ្ឋាននេះនឹងយោងតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធាន815នៃវិធានផ្ទៃក្នុងអវតកអង្គជំរះអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាចូលរួមតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពពីចម្ងាយពីបន្ទប់ឃុំខ្លួនមួយស្ថិតក្រោមសាធារណការនេះតាមរយៈឧបករណ៍សន្ទស្សន៍សម្រាប់រយៈពេលសកម្មភាពពេញមួយថ្ងៃនេះឲ្យបុគ្គលិកផ្នែកសន្ទស្សន៍ជាប់ប្រព័ន្ធសន្ទស្សន៍សម្រាប់ជនជាប់ចោតនួនជាអាចចូលរួមតាមដានកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពក្នុងឡងពេលនៃកិច្ចដំណើរការសកម្មភាពសម្រាប់ថ្ងៃនេះសួស្តីលោកស័ក្តិសីតើលោកឈ្មោះអី
បាទខ្ញុំឈ្មោះសៅចំពីហៅសៅម៉ាំង
ហៅឈ្មោះក្រៅហៅអីគេហៅសៅអីសៅមកតនមកតន
សៅម៉ាំង
បាទអរគុណអរគុណបាទហើយលោកប្រើប្រាស់ផ្លូវឈ្មោះផ្លូវការសប្ដថ្ងៃនេះប្រើឈ្មោះអីឈ្មោះសៅម៉ាំងឬក៏ឈ្មោះសៅចាំពី
ឈ្មោះសៅចំពីអឺសៅម៉ាំង
លោកមានអត្តសញ្ញាណប័ណ្ណទេលោកមានអត្តសញ្ញាណប័ណ្ណពលរដ្ឋសញ្ជាតិខ្មែរទេ
មានន
ៅក្នុងអត្តសញ្ញាណប័ណ្ណពលរដ្ឋខ្មែររបស់លោកលោកដាក់ឈ្មោះអី
ដាក់សៅម៉ាំង
បាទអរគុណលោកសៅម៉ាំងហើយលោកកើតនៅថ្ងៃខែឆ្នាំណាលោកចាំទេ
ថ្ងៃខែអត់ចាំទេឆ្នាំ1951
บ่าอกุ่นลูกสาวมังตาลูกเมธีกลายกำเนิดเนธีกลายหนา
ตีกำเนิดเนาหูมก่อมเยื้อสรกก่อแงกแฮดบันโดยกิรี
เจ้าตีลำเนินสับไงบรรลุตาลูกโรนเนตีกันไรนะ
ตีกำนัดสับไงเ
นาตีลำเนินตีลำเนินสับไงนะเตี้ยบรรลุสับไงรูลูกโรนเนตีกันไรนะ
เนาภูมโออามคุ้มเสกตุ้มสรกแก้วสีม้าแคดบันโดกรี
ออกคุณให้ลูกประกอบมกระโบเอาไปได้สักไงนี
้ประกอบมกระโบเธอจมกา
เออพวกประกาศบอลลูกชิมวยให้มาได้ประกาศระบอลลูกชิมวย
ปุกปังการสมัวนูมาได้ปังการสมัวบรอง
เจ้าผู้ปนบนลูกสมัวไอ้ให้ลูกมีโกนบนมันเนี้ย
ผู้ปนสมัวเป้าสุพีมีโกนรามเนี้ย
บ่าอกุณให้ตามระบายการរបស់កលាមជីសំណាកាថាតាមសមត្ថភាពដែលលោកឲ្យដឹងគឺលោកមិនមានជាប់ចំណងញាតិរហិតឬក៏ញាតិពន្ធជាមួយនឹងជនចាប់ចោតនួនជានឹងខៀវសំផននិងបកគលទាំងឡាយទទួលយកជាដើមម្ដងរដ្ឋបព្វនីក្នុងរឿងក្តីនេះទេតើពិតត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេរបាយការណ៍នេះ
ត្រឹមត្រូវ
ហើយលោកបានធ្វើសម្បត្តិរួចហើយនៅមុននឹងចូលមកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដោតសិក្ខាកម្មនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះនៅពេលនេះ
បានធ្វើរួចហើយ
បាទអរគុណតទៅនេះយើងប្រាប់អំពីសិទ្ធិនិងករណីកិច្ចក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាសាក្សីនៅចំពោះមុខអង្គជំរះលោកសៅម៉ាំងក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាសាក្សីនៅក្នុងកិច្ចដំណើរការនីតិវិធីតំណការចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនះនៅពេលនេះលោកអាចបដិសេធក្នុងការឆ្លើយតបទៅនឹងសំណួរឬសូមឲ្យលោកធ្វើអត្ថាធិប្បាយរៀបរាប់ដែលនាំឲ្យដាក់វិរុទ្ធភាពលើខ្លួនឯងគឺសិទ្ធិមិនធ្វើតខ័យកម្មប្រឆាំងនឹងខ្លួនឯងអំពីករណីកិច្ចនៅក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាសាក្សីលោកត្រូវតែឆ្លើយតបរាល់សំណួរទាំងឡាយដែលភាគីឬជាក្រុមនៃអង្គជំនះសួរចំពោះលោកលើកលែងតែសំណួរណាដែលនាំឲ្យចម្លើយតបរបស់លោកឬការធ្វើអត្ថាធិប្បាយរៀបរាប់របស់លោកនាំឲ្យដាក់វិរុទ្ធភាពលើខ្លួនឯងដោយយើងបានប្រាប់អំពីសិទ្ធិរួចហើយមិនមែននេះហើយក្នុងឋានៈលោកជាសាក្សីលោកត្រូវតែឆ្លើយឲ្យការណាដែលពិតដែលលោកបានដឹងបានឮបានឃើញបានចងចាំឬធ្លាប់មានបទពិសោធន៍ជួបប្រទះឬបានធ្វើការសង្កេតដោយផ្ទាល់នៅព្រឹត្តិហេតុនៅហេតុការណ៍ទាំងឡាយដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសំណួរដែលភាគីឬជាក្រុមនឹងអង្គជំនះសួរចំពោះលោកលោកសាងម៉ាំងតើលោកធ្លាប់បានផ្ដល់តខ័យកម្មឬក៏ផ្ដល់កិច្ចសម្ភារជាមួយនឹងអ្នកស៊ើបអង្កេតនៃការិយាល័យសហក្រមស៊ើបអង្កេតដែរឬទេក្នុងរយៈពេលកន្លងមកប្រមាណឆ្នាំកន្លងមកនេះហើយប្រសិនបើធ្វើប្រមាណដងធ្វើនៅកន្លែងណាធ្វើនៅពេលណាលោកចាំដែរទេ
ខ្ញុំបានធ្វើសម្ភារជាមួយលោកស៊ើបអង្កេតមួយដង
ធ្វើនៅកន្លែងណាដែរហើយលោកធ្វើនៅឆ្នាំណាដែរលោកចាំទេ
មិនចាំទេដូចឆ្នាំ
ចុះទីកន្លែងដែរធ្វើកិច្ចសម្ភារនោះធ្វើនៅកន្លែងណានៅផ្ទះរបស់លោកឬក៏នៅសាលាក្តីខ្មែរក្រហមនេះ
ធ្វើនៅផ្ទះនៅភូមិអូអាមឃុំថែកតុំស្រុកកែវសីមាខេត្តមណ្ឌលគិរី
អរគុណហើយមុនពេលចូលមកចំពោះមុខអង្គជំនះនៅពេលនេះតើលោកបានពិនិត្យមើលឬបានអានឬក៏ស្ដាប់ការអាននៅកំណត់ហេតុដែលលោកបានផ្ដល់សក្ខីកម្មកាលពីពេលមុន ជាមួយនឹងអ្នកស៊ើបអង្កេតនឹងផ្ទះរបស់លោកដើម្បីរំលឹកការចងចាំដែរឬទេ
មិនបានអានទេ ប៉ុន្តែ មាន អ្នកអាន ឲ្យ ស្ដាប់ បាន លឺ ហើយ ប៉ុណ្ណឹងទេ
ឯ តាម សមត្ថភាព ដែល លោក អាច ដឹង និង ចងចាំ បាន តើ លោក អាច បញ្ជាក់ បាន ដែរ ទេ ថា កំណត់ ហេតុ ដែល ផ្ដល់ ស្ដាប់ ចម្លើយ ដែល លោក បាន អាន បាន ស្ដាប់ ការ អាន ដើម្បី រំលឹក ការ ចងចាំ នោះ គឺ វា មាន ខ្លឹមសារ ត្រឹម ត្រូវ សម ស្រប ស៊ី សង្វាក់ គ្នា និង ចម្លើយ ដែល លោក បាន ផ្ដល់ កិច្ច សម្ភាស ជាមួយ នឹង អ្នក ស៊ើប អង្កេត នៅ នឹង ផ្ទះ របស់ លោក កាល ពី ពេល មុន នោះ ដែរ ឬទេ
អាច បាន
ខ្លះដែរបាទក្នុងការសួរដេញដល់សាក់សៃរូបនេះអនុវត្តតាមបទបញ្ញត្តិនៃវិធានការសួរមួយស្ទួននៃវិធានទៅក្នុងអង្គជំរះដល់វិធានការជូនទៅថាប្រញ្ញាសួរដេញដល់សាក់សៃរូបនេះមុនភាគីដទៃទៀតនៅរឿងក្តីហើយសាក់ប្រញ្ញារួមទាំងសាក់មិវីនៅមុខតំណាងដើមម្ដងរបស់រូបនេះមានរយៈពេល 2 វគ្គនៃថ្ងៃសាក់សម្ណាកាក្នុងការសួរដេញដល់សាក់សៃរូបនេះសូមអញ្ជើញ
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning,
Your Honor,
Council, Mr. Witness.
My
name is Dale Isaac, and I'm going to be asking some questions this morning on behalf of the prosecutors. Let's start with some questions about your background. Can you please tell the court what year it was that you joined the Khmer Rouge Revolution?
ចលនាចូលរួមជាមួយចលនាខ្មែរក្រហមនឹងក្នុងឆ្នាំណាដែរបាទខ្ញុំចូលចលនាក្នុងរបបខ្មែរក្រហមនឹងពីឆ្នាំ75រហូតដល់79
Did you become a party member at any time, and if so, when?
តើមានពេលណាមួយលោកខ្លាយជាសមាជិកបកនោះដែរឬទេហើយបើបានខ្លាយជាសមាជិកបកនោះតើលោកបានខ្លាយជាសមាជិកបកនៅឆ្នាំណា
ជាសមាជិកបកខ្ញុំមិនដែលបានធ្វើទេ
When did you first become a soldier in the Khmer Rouge Army?
Pel thua chia kong top nung hai tang pi chanam chet chet pram ra hot mo da chet chet pum buon.
Let me just get some clarification from you. In your OCIJ interview, you speak of 1974 rather than 1975. You said that in 1974, I was a private in a platoon in Fournier. Can you clarify, was it 1974 or 1975 that you became a platoon, became a private in a Cognier platoon?
ខ្ញុំមិនចាំដែរត្រង់ហ្នឹង
Let's talk about the period of the Khmer Rouge regime that is April 1975 to January 1979. What was your position in the Sector 105, the Mondulkiri sector military during the regime?
knong robob no lok ke chi kong toap dom bon 105 no lokri nung ke ko yang na
knong chnam 75 khom thoe chi kong toap dom bon lokri
You indicate in your OCIJ interview that you were the chief of a company, one of the three companies of Battalion 2 of the sector military. But when did you become a company chief in Battalion
2?
Đôi mình chạm thế tưởng về dù để
How many battalions in total were there in the sector 105 military?
Ta còn top đồng bọn 105 nó miền quân miền tuần màn còn đủ sinh hoạt thôn này.
មាន 2 អនុសេនាធំ
Those companies or battalions
តើទាំង2កងនេះទាំង2កងនេះគឺជាកងវិរៈសេនាតូចឬក៏ជាកងអនុសេនាធំ
2កងជាពីកងវិរៈសេនាធំហើយចែកជាវិរៈសេនាតូចមួយវិរៈសេនាធំមានវិរៈសេនាតូច3
And just to clarify whowho was the commander of the 1st Regiment and who was the commander of the 2nd Regiment, Regiment 2?
Kong Vresana Thom Lek Pi Mien Chmua Leng Chmua Vieng Hai Nung Khyom Patoal
And who was the commander of Regiment
1?
Kong Vresana Thom Lek Muay mien chmua Lan.
In your OCIJ interview, sir, you, rather than referring to these as regiments, you referred to them as battalions 1 and 2. Can you explain why did you refer to them as battalions 1 and 2 rather than regiments in your OCIJ interview? Can you clarify that for the court?
មានតែ2កងវិរៈសេនាតូចទេហើយពេលនេះវិញលោកថាមាន2កងវិរៈសេនាធំសូមបញ្ជាក់ឲ្យបានច្បាស់លាស់បន្តិចមើល
វាយូរហើយខ្ញុំក៏ដូចមិនសូវចាំដែរលោក
Now for the either regiment 2 or battalion 2 committee you identified 3 people Leng, Vieng, and yourself what were your respective positions and roles in the regiment or battalion 2 committee
គណៈកម្មាធិការកងវរៈសេនាធំឬក៏កងអនុសេនាធំលេខ2នេះមានតួនាទីធ្វើអ្វីដែរ
វរៈសេនាធំ lek pai men rneti nau prom den pi anusana to pi anusana thom vieng ke nau sra anusana thom khnyom tal nau sen manorom hai nang srok orang hai nang dak dam
in terms of your relative rank And in terms of the appointments of yourself, Laing, and
Laing,
to these positions, was it the secretary who made these appointments, or someone else?
Khang
Damban.
And does that mean that it was the sector's secretary at the who at the time was Laing, alias Hom? Was he the one who made the appointments?
Laing, or Hom, was the one who made the appointments?
So who was the chief of the Sector 105 military to whom the regiment matters, Laing and Laing reported? Who was the overall chief of the Sector military?
Lang, neckhead, slap.
Perhaps my question wasn't clear. I was asking about the chief of, not the sector secretary, but the chief of the sector military. Do you remember a person named
Tasapia?
And also, what was Tasapia's position in the sector? And was Tasapia the sector military chief? Were you related to Tasapia, at least as an
in-law?
He was the husband of one of your sisters, is that correct?
Tasapia ni chia phdai robo bong srai ko boun srai lok muay rup nu men te
bong srai
and And one of your brothers was Sao Serun. Is that correct?
And so can you tell the court
what position your brother Serun held
in Sector 105 during the regime?
Sao Serun, the admin, this is Sao Serun.
In your OCIJ interview,
you identified your third sibling, Sao Serun. No,
is he not the Sao Serun who testified in this court on a number of occasions? Apologize for my pronunciation. Your older brother, Sao Serun, what position did he hold in Sector 105 during the regime? Mr. Witness, a number of witnesses have testified that your brother's position the OCIJ interview of the person you've identified as the commander of Regiment 1, San Lamont. This is document E3-1650. E3-1650, Khmer 002-3-6-4-4-8-3-2, and former Regiment 1 Commander Lan
Is it correct that your brother became the secretary after the death of Maing?
And just to close out some of your family relations,
Do you have a brother, maybe your youngest brother, Lang, who was married to the daughter of Lang, Bun Si?
And what did that brother Bun Si, what did he do during the regime? Now you state in your OCIJ interview that you married your wife in 1974, was your marriage a traditional Khmer wedding, or was it one that was arranged and conducted by the Khmer party?
ឬក៏បាក់រៀបចំឲ្យលោកដែរ
អង្គការរៀបចំអស
់ Was the woman to whom you were married someone that you had known before your marriage? ស្ត្រីដែល
រៀបការជាមួយលោកនៅពេលនោះហ្នឹងដែរជាប្រពន្ធលោកហ្នឹងតើលោកធ្លាប់ស្គាល់ពីមុនមកដែរឬទេ
ស្គាល់បានទំនាក់ទំនងគ្នាឆ្លាញ់គ្នា
So this was a marriage that you wanted to do, the both of you. Is that correct?
អពាហ៍ពិពាហ៍ហ្នឹងគឺទាំងលោកទាំងសងខាងហើយនឹងលោកហើយនឹងប្រពន្ធលោកទាំងសងខាងគឺចង់ឲ្យរៀបការជាមួយនឹងគ្នាបានន័យថាអញ្ចឹងត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេ
ត្រឹមត្រូវ
Now you've already described for the court the primary function of your regiment 2 or battalion 2
indicated
a company was based in
Orang
district
Dakdam
area.
How
many soldiers were in the company that you
តាមានកងទ័ពឬក៏មានកងទ័ពប្រមាណអ្នកដែរដែលលោកដឹកនាំ
មានកងទ័ព100អ្នក
And so if there were three companies that formed
ដូច្នេះប្រសិនបើ3អនុសេនាធំអាចបង្កើតបានជាវរៈសេនាតូចមួយវរៈសេនាតូចនោះអញ្ចឹងបានន័យថាមួយវរៈសេនាតូចមានកងទ័ពប្រហែលជា300នាក់ត្រឹមត្រូវដែរឬទេ
ត្រឹមត្រូវ
And you've indicated that you were deployed to Orang. Where was the base?The office of Battalion 2.
មន្ទីររបស់កងវរៈសេនាតូចលេខ2ហ្នឹងឈរជើងនៅត្រង់កន្លែងណាដែរ
At yol de at yol
the Talang, who was the commander
Talang.
Of Battalion 2, or Regiment 2, where was his base, his office?
សួរនេះខ្ញុំសូមអរគុណតើសួរម្ដងទៀត
Let me try this a different way
មកតែខ្ញុំសូមសួរ
Let me read to you another excerpt from
វិញខ្ញុំនឹងអានកំណត់ហេតុស្ដាប់ចម្លើយរបស់មេបញ្ជាការរបស់ស្តាឡង
E3/1650
ឯកសារ E3 លើ1560ខ្មែរ00
7 3 7 3 1
English 0024 336 Barang mean lay 0024 7 4 8 9 8 30 2 9 8 30
This is what the former commander of Battalion or Regiment 1 said
នេះគឺមេបញ្ជាការវរៈសេនាតូចលេខ1លើកឡើងបានឆ្លើយនៅពេលនោះ mùa than rồi bảo vệ sân nhà tôi lấy muối cứ nữ khang lạch nôm cào
The base of Battalion 2
was at the Phnom Krao Dam,
which was about 1 kilometer away from Battalion
2. And the quote,
as testified by Battalion 1 Secretary Lan,
Lan
was your battalion number 2
that's headquarters of this
base at the Phnom
Krao Dam.
Is that where Ta Leng, the Battalion 2 commander, had his office? Or was he located somewhere else?
ទីតាំងរបស់ឡាន់ដែលសូមការតម្រូវគឺលេងដែលគាត់បោះទីតាំងនៅកន្លែងនោះឬក៏មូលដ្ឋានរបស់គាត់នៅកន្លែងផ្សេង
ទីតាំងគាត់នៅកន្លែងផ្សេងនៅជិតនឹង
was his locationat the sector military office that was known as
គាត់នៅមន្ទីររបស់តំបន់ហៅថាក11គឺកន្លែងដែលលេងនឹងឈរជើងនៅឬយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរ
គាត់នៅជិតនឹងដែរគាត់នៅខាងត្បូងបន្តិចនៅក11ណាហើយជិតគ្នាទីតំបន់
And is K-11 also where Ta Sophia, where his office was located? I want to turn now to some questions related to
what took place on the border.ហេតុការណ៍ដែលកើតឡើងនៅព្រំដែនដែលសាកសួរបានលើកឡើងនៅក្នុងរបបនោះ
លោកបាន
បញ្ជាក់រួចមកហើយថាគេបញ្ជូនលោកទៅអូរៀងស្រុកអូរៀងតើលោកអាចបញ្យល់ជូនតុលាការបានដែរទេតើ
នៅអូរៀងនោះ
នៅតំបន់កន្លែងណាដែរនៅព្រំដែនដែលគេបញ្ជូនលោកទៅឈរជើងនៅទីនោះ
នៅអរៀងនៅព្រំដែនគឺនៅខាងដាក់ដាំតើតដាក់ដាំតើព្រំបន្ទាល
់ And when was it that your company was sent to guard the border at
បញ្ជូនកងអនុសេនាធំរបស់លោកទៅដាក់ដាំនៅតាមព្រំដែននោះនៅពេលណាដែរក្រោយរំដោះឆ្នាំ70
1976
ឬក៏នៅក្នុងឆ្នាំ76
តាំងពីឆ្នាំ76រហូត79ជូនតា
And while your company was
guarding the border in Dakdam,
were there any other military units also stationed in that same area?
Specifically, what I'm interested in is whether there were any Division 920 units
that were also stationed in Dakdam and involved in responsible for guarding the border there.
How did you get to know the Dakdam and the Dakdam?
Mean gong top 920 now jit khnea nang.
Do you remember how many
ដែលលោកចាំទេកងទ័ពមកពី921នឹងមានប្រមាណអ្នកណាដែលគេបញ្ជូនទៅការពារព្រំដែននៅដាក់ដាំជាមួយនឹងកងទ័ពរបស់ខាងលោកនឹង
ខ្ញុំ អត់ ដឹង ជា ចំនួន ទេ ប៉ុន្តែ ឃើញ ដូច ច្រើន ដែរ
How is it that the assignment or tasks of your company
were
coordinated,
if at all, with West Division 920? My question is just,
was there coordination between the Division 920 and the sector military forces that were trying to guard the border, and how did that coordination work? Thank you for making that point, just to make sure it's clear.
The soldiers
in Division 920, if I understand correctly, they were not people from Mandalkiri, they came from other regions of the country, is that right?
ត្រឹមត្រូវ
There are a number of surviving documents that this is a 9 March 1976 report
from the Division 920,
Secretary Chin, Chief Brother 89, the alias for Son Sen, reporting on the situation at the border.
And it reads as follows,
Mr. Witness, I quote,
"They
have deployed their front troops along Odak Dam, including all types of weapons. They told us that in 4 days they would be deploying on our soil 5 kilometers away from the border. They also said that their army is the army of two. And told us to withdraw. There are 240 of them. They are well-armed, multi-types of weapons. The situation activities are now being monitored. Troops have been prepared to fight an additional 100
Chenda
forces and a DK reporter's rifle was sent. In this report, the Division 920 Secretary says that these 240 troops who came to the border said they were the army of two. Do you understand what that reference meant? Who the soldiers were who were tourists?
Let
me be more specific and just ask you a general question.
Do you remember during the time you were at the Dak Dam border whether there were soldiers
who came, who were former South Vietnam soldiers?
របស់ Việt Nam ខាងត្បូងដែរឬទេធ្លាប់ធ្វើជាកងទ័ព Việt Nam ខាងត្បូង
អត់តែឃើញទេ
And while I'm talking about other types of soldiers,
what
about full row? Do you remember any full row fighters being at the border? Did you know who full row was?
តើលោកស្គាល់ទេដឹងទេតើ full row ជានរណាដែរ
អត់ដឹងដែរ
When you wereDeployed to the Dakdam border area. Were you aware that there was a dispute between Vietnam and Democratic Cambodia
about where the border line was,
about who the territory belonged to? How did you know that there was a dispute between Vietnam and Democratic Cambodia?
អត់ដឹងទេ
ឡមីស៊ីហ្វអាយ
ខ្ញុំអាចព្យាយាមសាកល្បងតើខ្ញុំអាចជួយដើម្បីសាកមើលតើអាចលោកចងចាំដែរឬទេ
ដំបូងបំផុតគឺឯកសារ In the presence of their five-star commander, our people asked them what they were doing, and they responded that they were patrolling the border. Our people also talked with them about the border issue. They claimed that the land at the Vietnamese border area in Ho Rang and Olay was given by Sihanouk.
คือทางเสียนุบานเอาไปเวียดนามในไปได้ก่อนในไปกลางน้ำ51
first just something to clarify
มันจับการดอกสลับยมส้มมาสู้บัญช
ี who was group 7
ตากรมปมปัลน่ะพวกปมปัลน่ะคือเจียนอนาได้
អត់ដឹងទេ
Did you never hear
តើលោកមិនដែលធ្លាប់
ឮ Vietnamese or any parts of the Vietnamese at least
ថា
referred to by
ខាងវៀតណាមនោះ
your superiors as group 7
លោកហៅខាងវៀតណាមនោះថាជាពួក7ដែរឬទេ
អត់ដែលឮទេ
Let me ask you about another document on the same subject, this is border dispute. Your Honors, this is E3/217.
These are
minutes of the 26th March 1976 regarding the results of negotiations
ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងលទ្ធផលនៃការចរចាជាមួយនឹងវៀតណាមនៅតាមព្រំដែនខាងកើត
ឯកសារ
នេះគឺលើប្រធានបទនឹង របាយការណ៍មកពីអាយ៉ាជាលេខារបស់ខាងតំបន់ខាងបូព៌ាគឺតាក់ទងស្ថានភាពព្រំដែនជាមួយវៀតណាមនៅថ្ងៃឆ្នាំ1976ផ្នែក 1.1 កូនៃកំណត់ហេតុនៅត្រង់ទំព័រទី2ចំណងជើងថា
area between
តំបន់អូរៀងរវាងចន្លោះអូរដាក់ដាំនិងអូ
រ
ហើយនឹងតំបន់នៅដាក់ដាំនេះគឺជារបាយការ
ណ
៍ដែលតំណាងខាងវៀតណាមនោះបានលើកឡើងក្នុងអង្គប្រជុំ
He said that this
site was the most serious and made the accusation
that we had violated their territory by tens of kilometers. In that area, more than 50 of them had been killed or wounded. The discussions were tense, and everyone's necks were bulging, and facial expressions were drawn, and aides on bothTheir side, as well as ours, quit writing. Refresh your memory at all, Mr. Witness. Do you remember there being a rather intense dispute between Democratic Cambodia and Vietnam over the border territory and who it belonged to?
អំពីថាអ្នកណាកាន់កាប់ខាងណាអ្នកណាកាន់កាប់ខាងណាមេដវីដើម្បីឲ្យខ្ញុំអាចតាមទាន់ឯកសារអឺ3លើ217តើអឺ3លើ217ឬក៏យ៉ាងម៉េចលោកថាបទេញ៉ា
បាទខ្ញុំបានត្រឹមហើយ
ខ្ញុំសូមបងផ្ដល់ ERM ត្រង់ផ្នែកពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងតែម្ដង
ខ្មែរ
juste peut-être pour aider ceux qui suivent, c'est E3-218 et non pas
E3-217. មិនមែន217ទេលោកទៀត
Thank you council indeed I wrote the number down
សូមអរគុណលោកស្រីមេធាវីខ្ញុំបានសរសេរលេខយោងនៅទីនេះ
my apologies
បាទគឺ3លើ218ទេសូមអធិស្ឋានមិនមែន3លើ217ក៏ប៉ុន្តែ ERN លេខ ERN គឺត្រូវអត់ខុសទេ
Mr. Witness does hearing any of this
លោកសាក់សេ
ដែលរំលឹក
ខ្ញុំអានទៅតើលោកនៅនឹកឃើញទេដែលថានៅពេលនោះនេះពេលនោះនោះគឺចំនួ
នហ្នឹងហើយ
អំពីបន្ទាត់ខ្សែព្រំដែនហើយនរណាជាអ្នកកាន់កាប់កន្លែងណាឬកន្លែងណីនោះគឺមានការជជែកគ្នានឹងចំនួនហ្នឹងតឹងតែងណាស់តើលោកនឹកឃើញទេ
អត់ដឹងទេរិន
one more thing from the same document E3
ឯកតងឯកសារដដែលគឺនៅក្នុងឯកសារដដែល3លើ
218 the subsequent paragraph section 1.1d indicates that the Vietnamese had proposed liaison committees to be set up ស្នើសុំឲ្យបង្កើតគណៈកម្មការសម្របសម្រួល
គណៈកម្មការតាក់ទងគ្នាដើម្បីធ្វើការសម្របសម្រួលតាក់ទងគ្នាដើម្បីកុំឲ្យមានការវាយគ្នាទៅវិញទៅមកហើយនឹងដើម្បីជួយសម្រួលការធ្វើដំណើរទៅមកការរកស៊ីរបស់ប្រជាជនទាំងសងខាងកំណត់ហេតុនោះគឺបានបញ្ជាក់ថាតំណាងកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យបានយល់ព្រមតាមការលើកឡើងស្នើរបស់វៀតណាមគណៈកម្មការទៅតាក់ទង
Is indicated as including Comrade Sophia.
មណ្ឌលគិរីក្នុងនោះរួមបញ្ចូលសទ្ធិសុភាដែលជាមេកងទ័ពជាសមាជិកក្នុងគណៈកម្មការនេះផងដែរតើលោកនឹកឃើញទេថាសុភាមេបញ្ជាការកងទ័ពនៅពេលនោះម្នាក់នោះត្រូវបានគេតែងតាំងឲ្យ Joe Room, the Nokonong Kanakam got that tone, Nokonong Chanama Bobramon or Jets of Ramoy.
At Dante.
Let me ask you about the fighting on the border in that area. To your memory, what was the first time that there was any fighting or combat between DK and Vietnamese military forces at the Dak Dam border area?
So it's now 76.
And can you describe for the court what you remember in terms of how that fighting began?
Ampika vipayut ni na peno chap daam ka vipayut ni nung chap daam doi rabiam na dai.
Đôi mình chạm thế.
Were you present yourself when your company, the company you commanded, was engaged in fighting the Vietnamese troops?
And
can you tell the court about the fighting that took place between your company and Vietnamese troops at the Dak Dam border? How many Vietnamese soldiers were on the other side of this fighting?
Vietnam nung nơ khang kế nung miền bắc màn nẹt đài đài vì bây giờ chỉ mồi nung khang lục.
At đằng đấy sẽ đờ bạc nẹt đó có bây giờ tàu.
Now, I read to you some documents that showed there were negotiations at high levels taking place about this border area in March 1976. Do you remember whether the fighting took place before March 76, around the same time, or not until after
March 1976.
And from the time that these this fighting, sometimes minor, sometimes more major, started, how often was there fighting or combat between with the Vietnamese forces between 1976 and the end of the regime
ចន្លោះឆ្នាំ1976និង76រហូតដល់ពេលបញ្ចប់ហ្នឹងតើការវាយប្រយុទ្ធគ្នាហ្នឹងញឹកញាប់ប៉ុណ្ណាដែរ
76 មិនញឹកប្រហែលទេ 77 78 រហូតរត់ហ្នឹងគឺញឹកលោត អញ្ចឹង
And during 1977 and 78, when you say it became intensified, how regular was the fighting? Was it a daily, happening on a daily basis, a weekly basis? Can you give us some sense of how often the fighting was taking place in 1977 and 1978?
ចន្ទកាលមួយខែដល់ចន្ទកាលពីរខែដល់ម្ដងតែអញ្ចឹងដល់ 78 ហ្នឹងញាប់រហូតដល់ទៅរត់ឡើយ
Let me ask you now then about you said the time you fled. When was it that your troops retreated or fled? And can you describe to us what took place that caused your troops to retreat or flee?
Over
the course of this period in 1977 and 1978, where there was more intense fighting, how many casualties were there in your company of
100
soldiers? ແລະລະຈັດຈ່າຍໃຫ້ກະແນັກຄະຄັນຕ້ອງໂຕແຕ່ໂຕສໍາແບງໂຕອີ່ອັນນາອ້າຈັ່ງກະປະນຶງໂຕ
Just to clarify, I'm asking about through the entire time that you were engaged in combat, that is from 1976 through to the time that you fled in late 78 or early 79. Let me just, in your OCIJ interview, E3/506, Khmer 00239944, English,
Uncle
00244491, French 00289940. You said, I quote, some of my soldiers were wounded and some were killed in those losses. Can you give us an estimate of how many soldiers in your company were killed in the fighting between 1976 and through 1978?
កងទ័ពរបស់លោកនោះរបួសឬក៏ស្លាប់អស់ប្រមាណអ្នកដែរខ្ញុំឃើញកងទ័ពខ្ញុំរបួសពីរអ្នកស្លាប់ម្នាក់ក្នុងពេលប្រយុទ្ធ
And Do you know whether the Democratic Kampuchea military forces at the border there, either your sector military or Division 920, whether they planted spikes or mines along the border area in Mandalpuri? Did you use both mines and spike pits?
Look, that pungray, tang min, tang chum rong pong.
And where were these spikes planted? How close to the border? Let me, there are a few documents, surviving documents that have references to this. Let me just ask you a couple of questions about these. The first document, E3/9289, this is a report titled Summary of Situations from 15 July to 31 August 1976, Khmer ERN 00021506, English 00033965-966, French 01248464. And this is in a section that's a report from Division 920, 25 July 1976, in the morning, Group 7 fires M79 rifles at Dak Dam. And entry for 28 August 1976, Group 7 secretly comes to take off all of our mines. We then add some more mines and hidden spikes. Did you ever hear of that the Vietnamese were able to come and remove mines that had been planted by DK forces on the border? Do you know who it was that ordered the use of mines and spike traps on the border? Do you know if there were casualties, Vietnamese casualties, as a result of the mines or spike pits that were planted by the DK forces? Uh,
Mr. President, if I may, an observation.
No
objection, but I fail to see the relevance of these questions.
They're certainly not related
to any crimes or war crimes charged. We don't dispute
laying mines.
យើងមិនបានជជែកចំតតបាទគ្នាអំពីការដាក់ពង្រាយមីនយ៉ាងដូចនេះទេ
ហើយខ្ញុំស្ដាប់មើលទៅដូចជាមិនមានការពាក់ព័ន្ធគ្នាទេ
I don't understand the objection this is part of the ខ្ញុំអត់យល់ការចំតទេ
ដោយសារថានៅទីនោះមានការប្រយុទ្ធ
បន្តគ្នាហើយមានប្រើយុទ្ធវិធីកលយុទ្ធក្នុងការដាក់ពង្រាយមីននិងជំរងយ៉ាងដូចនេះ
នឹងគឺជាស្ថានភាពដ៏តឹងតែងមួយនៅក្នុងរបបនោះហើយ
It's clearly irrelevant to the armed conflict that's going on.
ណាស់ច្បាស់ណាស់ថាចំណុចនេះវាមានការជាប់ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងចំនួនប្រដាប់អាវុធហើយ
បន្តទៀតគាត់គាត់ទៅគាត់ទំគាល់ទេណា
Thank you, Mr. President.
សហប្រធានរងសូមអរគុណលោកប្រធាន
I wanted to ask you also about
ខ្ញុំក៏ចង់សួរលោក
whether there were Vietnamese soldiers or Vietnamese
កងទ័ពវៀតណាម
nationals or citizens
ឬក៏ជនស៊ីវិលវៀតណាមដែលបានចាប់ខ្លួននៅតាមតំបន់ព្រំដែនដែលឆ្លងចូលមកក្នុងបូរណភាពដែនដីកម្ពុជាប្រជាធិបតេយ្យនោះគេមានបានចាប់ខ្លួនទាំងទាហានទាំងស៊ីវិលនឹងដែរទេហើយបើមានចាប់ខ្លួនអញ្ចឹងតើគេចាត់ការឬធ្វើយ៉ាងម៉េចដែរជាមួយអ្នកដែលគេចាប់ខ្លួនបាន
អត់ដឹងទេ
Let me read to you one more document that's in evidence. This is E3/877. To Office 870. And paragraph 2 of E3/877. One second and one first lieutenant. And at the end of the telegram, it states, P.S. The problem of these contemptible Yuan has already been decided. This telegram from Secretary Maing specifically refers to some...presumably regiment or battalion 2 forces of the sector were deployed at Khao Sima and Srei Prea.
បាទអរគុណឥឡូវនេះដល់ពេលសម្រាប់ហើយអរមានឱកាសសម្រាប់ចាប់ទៅពេលនេះទៅទៅរហូតដល់ម៉ោង10កន្លះសូមអញ្ជើញចូលវិញដើម្បីបន្តកិច្ចដំណើរការសម្ដែងការមន្ត្រីរដ្ឋបាលអាការសម្រាប់រួមដល់កន្លែងសម្រាប់នៅផ្ទុករងចាំមេផ្សាក់ស័យដល់ស័ក្តិរូបនេះនៅក្នុងឡុងពេលជួបសម្រាប់អ្នកអញ្ជើញគាត់រួមទាំងមេធាវីប្រឹក្សាស័ក្តិមកកាន់កន្លែងផ្ដល់សេវាកម្មក្នុងផ្ទុកសម្ដែងការនេះវិញនៅវេលាម៉ោង10កន្លះសម្រាប់ចុះ